Hello everyone. So today we see about spring. Okay, what is the spring framework is called? It is a advanced topic of Java where we can have a web applications. Using the spring frameworks, we can develop a web applications. Okay, if you have a clear understanding of JSP servlet or a client server, how it is working in the project, that is helpful to learn the spring, because the frameworks is really works on the view side. As of now, we know model view controller. The Spring is works on the view side, the view between the views and controller. Okay? How the request and response is handling. Okay, so if a clear understanding, the Spring will be easy to learn. The Spring is a lightweight framework. So it is also framework. It is lightweight frameworks. Whereas application will be faster, more performance will be more faster. So it is be thought of as a framework of frameworks. Okay, we have a framework called Stux Hibernate. You know, it is a framework for a Hibernate frameworks. Okay, it will be works on above the layer of the Hibernate. If you are using the Hibernate, then the Spring will be can be used, or is not being used. Okay, it supports some of the various frameworks, Stux Hibernate and Raspberry and EJP and JSP. As of now, JSP is Java Server Page. Is a Java Server Page. So what is the advantage of a Spring? Okay, so it's called predefined templates. We have a if you want to use a customized design, okay, we have predefined templates so that we can use HTML's own tags. The Springs have some tags, we can use it in the HTML so that it can provide some custom data. Okay, loosely coupled, so it's not dependent, it don't have any dependency. Okay, then easy to test. So if you want to test, you know, we have a mini jar over there. We can use in the jar, we can have a test over there. It's lightweighted. The loading process timing will be getting very low when you're using a Spring in a web application. The fast development. Using a Spring, it will provide all the tools. No need to worry about the long code. So we can provide all the codes. So it should be simplified coding method will be followed in the Spring framework. The powerful abstract, so it will be more secure. And a declaration supports. We have a many supports. We have declarations. If you need anonymization, we have a many supports over there. Let's come to the architectures. How the Springs is works. So here in left we have one called data access integration. Okay, either will be JDBC or RDBMS or OxygenJS transaction. It can be works in the web content like web socket or servlets or web processes. The frameworks will be in the holding all the component, like here the model, here the controller was the left side, right? So left side was the model, right is the controller. The AOP and aspects instruments messaging. So if you are using this functionality, the framework Spring framework is very useful. So the core container like bean, core, context and spell, this will be the core container where we can have a Spring framework. So easy to use. The test is our applications where we run it, where the actual we see what is application. So this is the architecture where the Springs works. Okay, this will be more discussed. So in this tutorial we discuss about short note of the Spring. Okay, in later tutorial we can have a detailed how we can develop on a Spring applications. Okay, using Hibernate or without Hibernate, how we can develop, you can see on the next tutorial. Thank you for watching this video.